Good morning, dear students. How are you? Are you boring without English class? Yes or no? There is a good news for you. You are going to have your learning activities just by sitting at your homes. Are you happy? Of course. Dear students, asking questions is a part and parcel of our lives. Questions comes to our minds like anything. Some are easy and some are difficult. We ask questions for answers. We need answers because we want to do everything correctly and in the best way possible so that we can be successful in life. Today, we are going to learn the first unit, Three Questions by Leo Tolstoy. This story is written in two parts. The first part begins with a king who wanted to know answers to his three questions because he thought that he would be successful in all his business and undertakings if he knew answers to these questions. The three questions were, first, what is the right time to begin a thing? Some people suggested that the king had to prepare a timetable and follow it strictly. Some said that he needed some wise men to guide him. Others asked him to consult magicians. What was his second question? It was, which people should he listen to for his guidance? The answer was that he should consult magicians, priests, doctors, and soldiers. What was his third question? It was, what was the most important thing for him to do? To this question, the wise men told the king to give importance to science, fighting, and religious worship. But the king was not satisfied with these solutions. Finally, the king decided to seek the advice of a hermit who lived alone in a forest. He walked to the hermit's hut and asked his three questions to him who was digging the ground. The hermit gave no answer. The king then took the spade and started digging the ground. Before the king left the place, a bearded man came running to him. The second part begins with the bearded man running towards the cottage. He was wounded and bleeding in the stomach. The wounded man fainted and fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed his clothes. They washed the wound in his stomach. The king covered it with his handkerchief and redressed the wound as the bleeding did not stop. Then the king and the hermit carried the wounded man into the hut and put him on the bed. But who was the wounded man? The wounded man was the brother of the man whom the king had killed. The king had also captured his property. So, the bearded man had decided to take revenge and kill the king. He was now grateful to the king for saving his life. And he asked for the king's forgiveness. The king made peace with him and promised to return his property. Before leaving for the palace, the king requested the hermit to answer his three questions. Hermit's three answers were: first, the most important time was when the king was digging the ground for the hermit. So, king's most important business was to help the hermit. The second answer: the most important time was when he was dressing the bearded man's wound. Service done to him was king's most important business. The third answer: the most important time is now or the present. The most important person is with whom one is at the moment. The most important business is to do good to that person. Students, these three pieces of advice were the best for the king, and they are also the best for all of us. Now, what would be the moral of the lesson? The moral is: the best way to defeat our enemies is by loving them. Once again, the best way to defeat our enemies is by loving them. Thank you, students.